Alright guys, welcome back to map making. So as you know, I haven't been doing any building recently, and the reason why I haven't been doing any building is because it's just not really interesting me at the moment. But what is interesting me is a... God, so much map making. I've got a lot to show you. I'm not going to be able to get it all in one video, but I'll show you the best bits, I think. So the most important thing is what I'm going to show you first, and then I'll do some less interesting stuff later. So this is the main subject of the video, continental scale map creation. So let's load up this one. Okay, so I've spent 4 days or something like that making this, and this is well, if you're not familiar with World Machine, this basically is... Oh, God. Well, if you're not familiar with World Machine, this is just a load of boxes. If you are familiar with World Machine, or you've watched my previous videos about it, each one of these lines here is a specific type of terrain. So this one right here is mountainous, and it starts off from making a mask. So this is the basic mountain layout. That was a truck. It goes through all sorts of things, thermal weatherings, advanced... Blah, 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 blah. And basically ends up with this, and this is just a very simple, this is where the mountains are going to be. So if I rendered this out as a map, it would work, and you know, obviously when it's rendered it doesn't look too good now, but when I actually do a... this is a 2k by 2k map, so this is quite big. No, it's 2k. I thought it was 3k, but no, it's 2k by 2k, so it's quite a large map, but not massive. I think 2k by 2k is a good size map for most things. You know, obviously in very high populated servers you want the bigger map, but 2k by 2k I think is suitable for most stuff, depending on, you know, what you're doing. Anyway, so there's the mountains. Then there's foothills, which are a lot smoother, but still they've still got rocks on them and stuff. I keep pressing open instead of this button. We have hills. These are actually one of the hardest things to make, because making realistic hills is really difficult. I think it worked out though. I'll show you them in game and then you can decide for yourselves. So there's the hills, then there's the beach layer, which is just very 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 flat because obviously it's for beaches, and then the seabed, which is just kind of a little... it's got like little bits of rock, which should make some interesting kind of islands. And they all go into this thing called the height chooser. Now the height chooser basically takes an input, and this up here is the input. I'll go through that in a second. And it decides which piece of terrain should go into each input. So the lowest values, which is our seabed, goes in there, and the highest values, which is our mountains, goes in here. So if I take a look at this, this is just an advanced plan that I made. It's randomly generated, so I could just keep on hitting randomize until I get the kind of rough terrain I want. Then it goes to a terrace, which splits up into 5 layers. Each one of these layers represents a new type of terrain. So basically, everywhere there is this white, that's where mountains are going to be. Everywhere there's grey, that's foothills. Everywhere there's this colour is hills. Green is beach, and then the dark green is seabed. That goes to a clamp, so now you can see the layers more clearly. And then it goes to a layout generator, and this layout generator is where, you know, this is where I get to choose where stuff goes. So I chose that this is going to be the ocean, and there's one river basin here, there's another river basin, just a really small one going up here, and this is where the mountains are going to be, all around the edge and in the middle. There's also a beachy area here. Yeah, so that goes through that. Then it goes to another layer generator where I carved in my my rivers. And the rivers look very destructive, and this is why this type of terrain making is really really good, because it means that I can be very destructive with this layer, as this doesn't look good at all. But what's important is I can change stuff really easily because it's such a light layer. If I come into my view here, see, I could just change the shape of this river with one click. I'm not going to because it'll mess up the map, but I can out here. I can just drag that, and now the river's changed shape. I don't have to reposition mountains. I don't have to reposition mountain ranges. I don't have to do any of that fucking around. The whole thing is just controlled by these shapes you see right here. Oh, God. Selection thing's gone a bit weird. So the red ones are negative shapes, the green ones are positive shapes. So I've got a big positive shape here which just cuts down, and this negative shape which then conflicts with this positive shape to create these mountains over here, this mountain range in the middle, and this does the riverbed, and these two boxes here just do the mountains around the outside. So I can change stuff really simply, and that's the key to this. So it goes into the height chooser, and you can see now we have mountains around where the white was. There's that little splodge in the middle. You can see the river basins quite clearly. And then we've got the mountains around the edge. Foothills over here. No, foothills are all around here actually, but this is the hill, just the normal hills. There's our beach around that area. Yep. So then that goes through an erosion filter. Now it's quite important that the erosion has... it doesn't erode the rivers. If I didn't use this mask input onto the erosion, the rivers would just be gone. So when it goes to this erosion, obviously it's already all the terrain's already been eroded on most of these things. This one's actually got two thermal weathering and two erosion filters for the mountains. So they're already pretty eroded, but I have to add that extra level of erosion just to blend everything together. So I take the river layout generator and I put it through an inverter and a clamp just to use it as a mask so that it doesn't fuck up the rivers too much. I did have a coastal erosion. I decided not to use that. I think it's too destructive and it creates too kind of clean cliffs, so I decided to do the coastal erosion myself. It goes through another advanced purlin, which just adds a little bit of noise to everything, just getting rid of those smooth edges created by the erosion. All this down here, this is just color making, and if I click through these you can see it builds up the color, and this is extremely useful for the world painter process. Basically the pink is sea, the blue is beach, the green is hills, the yellow is foothills, and the red is mountains. So this is very useful when I'm choosing my biomes, and I'll show you that in a bit. And that goes into this overlay view, so I can just check out the landscape and just see how it's all been influenced. This overlay view has all of my kind of coloration in it. This isn't important, but I have done a few TerraGen renders, and I will show you them. I think I'm going to show you them in a different video, because there's quite a lot to go through in that. But yeah, this basically just makes it look pretty in the preview screen, so I can kind of get an idea of elevation, because you know, obviously this light green is the hills, this dark green is the foothills, and it looks pretty, which yeah, always feels good. This is the height output, this just exports the map. And this is the bitmap output, which exports this image right here. Everything here is just for making the colors, making everything look pretty. Everything down here is just for making these colors. So this bit here, this is all the map, the terrain generation and stuff. Yeah. So you notice I don't use noise anymore. I've refined that a lot. I use an advanced purlin instead of noise, because noise kind of creates these... lone blocks that will split off from a contour and be on their own, and they just look really ugly and weird, whereas using advanced purlin means that everything will be kept a little bit more together, which is great. I think that's everything I can show you on the actual world machine front. So now we're going to go into world painter. Now I'm going to hide some layers here because they're a bit daunting. Let's hide all these custom layers here. Yeah, so the only change I've made to the terrain is I've added two pyramids here. I'll show you them in game. They look kind of funny. I was just testing that to see how they'd look. I'll open up Minecraft now. So yeah, here's the terrain. You can see that we've got not too many very smooth slopes. Now ignore this frost. This frost is deliberately smooth. So that's to achieve the smooth snow layer. I use the smooth brush with a mask, so it only affects the snow, and only works on below 20 degrees, which means that it doesn't touch our mountains, it just smooths out the area where the snow will actually be, which is very useful. Let's just load this up. So I created a new snow brush, and I can actually show you how I made that. Oh no, I can't. I forgot to save the file. Okay, so I made a new snow brush, and I'll just demonstrate it by turning on this layer. You can see this is the rough shape of the snow brush. I made this just by making a mountain, eroding it a lot, eroding it a fuckload, and then selecting a certain slope level, and then turning that into a black and white image and exporting that as a brush. so I can use that to make these really nice transitions. And I've used this a hell of a lot. I'm planning on making a few more just to add a bit of variation, but you can see this snow layer has got nice shapes coming out of it. The most important thing about these shapes is they're interesting, and they kind of create the illusion that the terrain is a little bit more complex than Minecraft allow it to be. Oh, stretch! Jesus Christ. Ugh. Totally did not just wake up that ridiculously late in the morning. Oh dear. In the mountains, in the river, you may notice this weird shape, and the reason for that is because when I used this layout, this is kind of hard to show. Okay, so here's what I exported from the layout. This is the river, so as you can see, it's very dark in the middle, and then it kind of comes out. The reason for that is because if we take a look at the curve for this line, this one actually appears to have a normal fallout curve. Oh, that's weird. Oh, that's very weird. I thought I used a custom curve. Maybe I decided not to do that. If I use this as a mask for the erosion, it would mean that there would be no erosion near the rivers, and I don't want that at all. But I need to make sure that the river always goes through, so basically I would never want the banks to meet, and that was a problem I was having. So I clamp it. If you look in the top left, you can see the difference between that one and that one, and this clamp basically just means that everywhere there is black, there will be a river. There is no way that there cannot be a river. There will 100% be a river, but we want to minimize the lack of erosion as much as possible, and it actually worked out brilliantly. It just so happened that this thickness here is just the right thickness in game that it doesn't matter that there's no erosion, because it's so thin you can't see it anyway. So yeah, that worked out really well. As I was just lucky. Right, so back to World Painter. Yeah, you can see these bits here. So I went through a huge amount of processes that I'm not going to go into in order to create all the rocks and the biome colouring, but basically these are all the tree layers. If I just show all of these. Yeah, so the red is small pines, the blue is tall pines, this dark blue down here is deserty trees, and the yellow is just normal kind of deciduous. And now the important thing about this map is that if I leave, what is the word? Hold on, let me just go to export and see. Yes, population. I leave population on. I can't believe I forgot that word. So there's a lot of normal Minecraft trees, and you know, all the animals that should spawn will spawn. Everything will spawn. I couldn't have structures on, because structures always work nastily with custom terrains, but theoretically I could turn on structures and they probably could work. Let's just turn on the biome filter so you can see that. So obviously the snow is covered in taiga biome and stuff like that, but quite importantly is this blue biome here. This is ocean biome, and so you can see that this blue is the ocean biome, which, as I asked Monsterfish to slightly change the biome coloring for the ocean, just be a little bit lighter. So that is exclusive to the Conquest texture pack, but you know, obviously you could just replace the ocean with whatever lighter biome is in your particular texture pack. And down here there's some desert biome, but I will show you that in game. So I think that's everything I can show you on World Painter. So let's go in game and take a look around. I'm going to be lagging quite bad because Fraps doesn't agree with my Minecraft, but oh no, that seems to be okay. It's just slow world loading. Where am I? Okay, I'm in the beach area, so I am currently right here. I don't know if you can see my cursor, but I'm right here. And I'm going to travel up the river, take a look at the desert, and then go up to the mountainous area. So this map creation technique actually creates some really interesting landforms, and I was really happy with that. Here's an example of how the snow layer works. I think it works really nicely. It's just the right blend of noise and kind of cleanness. Because if normally I just go for either massive noise or massive clean, and both of which look very weird. So this is a good blend of the two. So you can see this is what most of the coast looks like. You know, cliffs leading up to a beach. But not all the cliffs, and that's important. Some of the terrain just kind of worked nicely. Anyway, I was supposed to be going to the river. Let's go to the river. Here's the trees. These are just the normal trees. Now, here's some interesting biome coloration that went into the coast. Completely accidental, but worked really nicely. It's because of the slopes underwater. But that works great. Yeah, so obviously we've got all the beach layer completely intact, which can sometimes be ugly. I mean, you've got the big patches of clay, but the important thing is that this terrain is, like, I could play this on survival and I'd never notice. Here is the entrance to the river. Now take a look at this pattern. That looks good. Completely accidental. Don't know how that happened. This is ocean biome and this is plains biome. So yeah, I don't know, just kind of creates these great patterns. They work a lot better inland, but yeah. Here is our desert. So it's not particularly huge, but then the map is only 2k by 2k, so the map isn't particularly huge. Here's the desert trees we have. Not many of them, which is important because you don't want too many. Here's the mountains bordering the whole map, so you kind of don't want to cross them. Unless you end up with a weird world, but there's some more of the trees. Here you can see the desert colouring on the grass, which works really nicely, actually. I like this blend of grass and desert. If it's just purely desert, I think that looks a bit weird, and I don't like that. Here's the river that comes up into the desert. There's the pyramids. So you can see this is where the river should have been. It should have gone straight down there, but it was too wide. The erosion has brought in this bit of land here, and then it's gone because of that thick black shape I told you about. So what we need to do here is just put like a spring in this piece of water and have it flow down, and this would look almost completely natural, which is great. Especially on a terrain of this scale with, you know, I mean, I could spend ages doing these rivers manually by hand, but I don't have time for that. I'm all about automation with terrains. I think it's really fun to automate. So there's the edges of the desert. You can see same brush again, and it creates these great shapes. But I'm planning on doing some more of these custom shapes for different things. Here's the pyramid. I really roughen them up quite a lot. You see there's bits of sandstone, like cracks going through them. This one's a little bit too tall, the angles are a bit steep, but yeah. The point of these pyramids was just to see whether I could make a pyramid that looked natural. I mean, obviously it's made by a person or people, but I wanted it to look like it could. You just find a pyramid, that's fine. It doesn't necessarily mean that there was an NPC village anywhere nearby or anything like that. It just means that sometime in the ages somebody has built it, which is cool. Another great thing about this map is it seems that you can always see a different biome. I think that's quite important. I mean, there's places where you can't, but here I'm standing in the desert and I can see where I have to go to get to a plains or a forest or a, you know, an alpine, and that's really good. It's really good for a server map or for any kind of map, really. Is this streak still coming up? We're just going to keep following this terrain. Here's my favourite bit with these kind of colours. You can see the two flows meeting. I like that. I love that a lot. That's interesting, actually. This flow is where the... you know, I was talking about that black line. That's exactly where that black line is. Ooh, that lava is ugly. It looks like it's fading. Yeah. So everywhere this kind of dark flow is, that's where the river will 100% be, and you can see that it becomes 100% over here, which is actually a really nice bit of river. I like this, and again it ends quite abruptly, but all you need is a waterfall coming from up there, just one bucket of water, and it will work. It's actually a place where in it there's another river where this river here, Minecraft actually placed a block of water up on this cliff and it flowed down. I might be able to show you that, but yeah, that's nice. Here you can see the biome colouring differences. So this is the plains biome down here, and this is the ocean. And you can see that it's got these great shapes kind of leading up that look like they've been made by, well, flows and stuff. It's good. I like it. I really like this biome colouring up here. It just feels just slightly colder and slightly more hospitable. Inhospitable, even. There's a bit of snow. That bit of snow actually didn't work. Neither did this bit. I need to fix them. So there's another forest. And then here is the kind of... This is the main mountain. This is right in the middle of the map. You can see we've got a thick snow layer on top. I don't actually like this mountain very much, but that's just the part of the generation process. You end up with some shapes you don't like, but it works. I mean, it's an iconic shape, so that's good. Here's the bucket of water I was telling you about. It randomly placed a block of water there, and it flows in this disgusting flow, but I mean, it wouldn't be hard to fix with a few clicks. There we are, so there's that river. Let's go take a look at some of the mountains. I need to show you the hills. This would be the hills down here. Yeah, so it looks kind of hilly. It's just rolling hills. It's kind of more like a plains biome, but it's a bit hilly, which is kind of what I wanted. I think I might bring the hills a bit closer together though, but we'll see. Let's go over here. This should be the tallest mountain in this map. Should be over here somewhere. Ah, here's the tall trees. I have a feeling these trees might be a bit too tall. They kind of dwarf the mountains. Yeah, I'm not sure about those trees. I think I might tone those down. But I believe this, yeah, there it is. That's the tallest mountain in the map. So if I come all the way down to sea level, you can see it's quite large. And looks quite interesting. Oh, that's a problem. There's another bug I need to fix. There shouldn't be any snow on top of these rocks. But, yeah, that's easily fixed. And there it is. Yes, I need to fix this mountain. Anyway, I'm going to make another video at some point saying about how you can get this map. I'm going to need to start actually selling maps in order to pay rent. as I said, I'll do that in a different video because not many people who watch this will be interested in actually paying money for it because, well, it's... it feels weird asking for money for maps, but I gotta do it. So I'll do that in another video. So thanks for watching, guys. If you enjoyed this, please don't forget to leave a rating, and I will see you next time.